बच्चों, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल। मैं आपके सामने सुशील कुमार नए टॉपिक के साथ, और आज का हमारा टॉपिक है फ्रैक्शंस, एनसीईआरटी चैप्टर 2, राइट? तो बने रहिए मेरे साथ वीडियो पे। व्हाट इज फ्रैक्शन विद द हेल्प ऑफ डायग्राम्स आल्सो आई विल अंडरस्टैंड यू एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ डेफिनेशंस, राइट? फ्रैक्शन अ नंबर दैट कैन बी expressed in the form of a by b is called a fraction, right? Is called a fractions. Okay, where this is very important, where a and b are natural numbers, a and b are natural numbers, right? Okay, तो बच्चों ये देखो, अगर आप लिखते हैं a by b is a fraction, this is a fraction, and very important thing, this is known as numerator, right? This is known as numerator and this is known as denominator, right? Denominator. Okay, so the number above this slash is no bar is known as numerator, and this number is b is known as denominator. Okay, sometime we can write the definition of fraction as a part of whole is called a fraction. Okay, a part of whole is called a fraction. Okay, so a part of whole means sometime you are dividing a pizza into two equal parts or three equal parts or four equal parts, right? So each part become a fraction. Now we are taking some examples. Okay, 7/9 is a fraction, fraction. 7/9 is a fraction where 7 is numerator and 9 is denominator. Okay, so I think you understand better what is a fraction. Similarly, we can take one more example, 9/5, right? This is also a fraction. This 9 is known as numerator and this 5 is known as denominator, right? Similarly, so many examples we can take. One more important thing, प्यारे बच्चों, एवरी नेचुरल नंबर इज अ फ्रैक्शन. यू कैन राइट एवरी नेचुरल नंबर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फ्रैक्शन. हाउ? देखिए, आप ले रहे हैं 7, राइट? दिस इज 7, सो आई कैन राइट 7 एज 7/1, दिस बिकम फ्रैक्शन, एंड 7 इज अगेन न्यूमिरेटर एंड दिस 1 इज डिनोमिनेटर. ओके, so every natural number is can be represented as in the form of natural number or in a form of fraction. With the help of examples I am going to explain. Bane rahiye video pe, abhi hum kuch examples lete hain, right? So try to understand with the help of diagram. This is a circle, right? And I am dividing this whole part. This is your pizza. Okay, I'm dividing this your pizza into four equal parts. Okay, I'm going to shade this part. This is your shaded part. Okay, so how many total parts this pizza have? This is 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? Four parts. And how many parts are shaded? This is the shaded part, right? And these three are, this is 1/4 part, this is 1/4, this is 1/4, and this is also 1/4 part, right? So you can write shaded part is equal to 1/4, right? And node shaded part is equal to 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. You can say 1 plus denominator is same, so you can write denominator here, not a problem. 1 plus 1 plus 1 become 3, right? Similarly, you can take many more examples. Okay, I am taking this triangle. This is a triangle, right? So, and I am going to divide this triangle again into many parts, right? These are the four equal parts of this triangle. So, I am going to shade this part. Okay, this is the shaded part of this triangle. How many total parts this triangle have? Again, four parts. So, this is called 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4 and 1 by 4. Right? So, shaded part is equal to 1 by 4 and again, node shaded part is equal to 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. It becomes 3 by 4, right? Similarly, we can take more examples. Okay, this is a circle, right? And I am going to divide this circle into 3 equal parts. This is center of the circle and I am dividing this circle into 3 equal parts, right? So now I am going to shade this part, right? Each part is equal to 1 by 3, right? Because this part is whole. One circle is called whole. Mean 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 become 1. Mean one circle. Similarly, in case of triangle, right? I am taking these 3 examples. C part. So here you will write shaded part is equal to how many? This is only one shaded part, that is 1 by 3. Okay? And node shaded part is equal to 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 become 2 by 3. Right? 2 by 3 is node shaded part. So, total, what is the total parts? 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3. Right or not? Your denominator is same, so you can add directly. 1 plus 2 become 3. 3 by 3 is equal to 1. Mean total circle is 1. So, you will better understand with the help of example. You can take this type of many more examples to understand the fractions, right? And fraction, one more important thing regarding fraction is fraction cannot be negative. Okay? Fractions can't be negative. Always remember, fraction can't be negative, right? Because you cannot take negative part of the pizza. You can take zero part of the pizza, mean you are not taking the pizza, right? But you cannot eat zero negative part of the pizza. Mean fraction cannot be negative. Always remember. If you are writing like this, अब आप कहेंगे सर minus 7 by 9 is written somewhere. Okay? So is this not a fraction? No, this is not a fraction. Minus 7 by 9 is not a fraction. This is a rational number. Okay? That you will learn later on. In this class only and in class 8 also. Okay? So minus 7 by 9 is not a fraction. This is a rational number. Right? If any of the numerator or denominator is negative, any one, then you can say that is not a fraction. Okay? Always remember this. बने रहिए मेरे साथ वीडियो पे. अभी हम करेंगे types of fraction, different types of fractions, right? Okay.